डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट ल्यूकोसोलेनिया. ल्यूकोसोलेनिया इज ऑल्सो ए पोरिफेरिन एनिमल. इट ऑल्सो हैव कैलकेरियस स्केलेटन लाइक साइकन. इट इज ए ब्रांच स्पंज दैट रिमेन वेरी स्मॉल इन साइज, नियर अबाउट 2.5 सेंटीमीटर इन लेंथ. दे ग्रो इन colony of cylinder is individual by a common root like process. Water enters the central cavity through numerous perforation, that is also we can say ostia. To bring water into the animal, coenocytes beat their flagella to whisk water inward, where the water is filtered for nutrients. The body of the animal is supported by skeletal spicules that are found within the mesoglia. Reproduction can either be sexual or asexual, depending on the environmental conditions. Now we will talk about habit and habitat. Leucosolonia are widespread genus that can be found attached to the substrate within tide pools and on wharves. It is a small, delicate branching colonial marine sponge. It grow in slow water below the low tide mark on seashore rope, where wave action is intense and is not found in calm water. Leucosolenia is also found abundantly along the northern Atlantic coast and is supposed to be very sensitive to external conditions. About 100 species of Leucosolenia have been reported from different seas in all over the world. Leucosolenia botrytis, Leucosolenia complicata and Leucosolenia variabilis are common species that can be seen everywhere in the world. Now, structure of Leucosolenia. The colony of Leucosolenia is whitish yellow in color. It is simplest species of Leucosolenia. In the simplest species of Leucosolenia, the colony consists of few simple vase like cylindrical individuals, each terminating in an osculum and united at their bases by irregular horizontal tubes. Most species are more complicated, consisting of a confused network of branching tubes from which stand out a few large erect cylinder like or cylinder bearing osculum at their summit. Finally, in the most complicated species, the outermost tube fused together and form a false surface or pseudoderm, leaving a few large opening or the pseudopores, so that the sponges appear solid and stimulate a higher type of sponge. But sections show the network of Ascone tubes in the anterior. Each tube of the colony may reach up to 25 mm in height. It means the length of the Leucosolenia is about 2.5 centimeter, and it also produced a number of buds. Its main tube open to the exterior by an aperture called osculum, as we have earlier mentioned or discussed. The cavity of the tube is known as spongocoel or paragastric cavity. Now we will discuss about body wall. The body wall is thin and consists of an outer epidermis, the pinacoderm. It means the outer epidermis is also known as pinacoderm, and an inner epidermis that is also known as coenoderm, separated by a jelly-like non-cellular layer of mesenchyme, as we have discussed in Cycan. The mesenchyme is also known as mesoglia, enclosing a central cavity. The spongocele. The wall of each tube is perforated by numerous pores through which water enter the spongocele and pass out by osculum. Here we are seeing the diagram, osculum, and the porocytes, mesenchymes, coenocyte cells, some other cells that we can also include in amebocytes, and the spongocele and osculum by which water come out. First is pinacoderm or the outer layer. The outer epidermis consists of thin, scale-like, flagellated cells called pinacocytes. Pinacocytes is a Greek word which pinaco means plank and kite means cells, which lie with the edge touching and forming a single layer of cells called pinacoderm. This layer forms the outer protective covering of the tube. A pinacocyte has thin, highly contractile margins and contain a central bulging having nucleus. Second is coenoderm. The inner epithelium consists of a single layer of coenocyte cells and form the lining of spongocele and also refer to gastrodermis. The coenocytes word is also a Greek word. It means coeno means funnel and kytos means cell. A coenocyte is an oval cell. Oval means like egg. The coenocyte is an oval cell having a flagellum which arises from basal granules and is surrounded at its base by a contractile transparent protoplasmic collar. The nuclei of coenocyte lies at the bases of cells. The beating of the flagella of coenocyte cells maintain a water current in the body of sponge. Third is mesenchyme or mesoglia, that is lies between the pinacoderm and coenoderm. Mesenchyme is the intermediate layer between the pinacoderm and coenoderm. Mesenchyme is a thin layer and is in form of gel. It is secreted by the coenocytes and it holds the skeletal elements of calcium carbonate called spicules or sclerites in place. In the mesenchyme are some amebocyte cells also there, which are also called amoeboid cells. They wander about freely. These cells contain RNA and self-replicating in nature. These cells can give rise to different type of cells, as we have discussed in Cycan. Hence, it is totipotent in action. They may give rise to pinacocytes or coenocytes, colonocytes, sclerocytes, or scleroblast and reproductive cells. It means they can produce all type of cells, hence they call totipotent. The spicules are crystalline, needle-like, which are monoxone. It means one rays, tetraxone means four rays, or traxene, three rays. The spicules are secreted by scleroblast cells and remain embedded in the mesenchyme. And some monoxone spicules project out of the pinacoderm. A few monoxone spicules form a scanty fringe around the osculum. Ostia. The wall of each tube is pursed or perforated by numerous pores called ostia or incurrent pores, which pass through a space or lumen of cells called porocytes. The porocytes are supposed to be modified pinacocytes. Each ostium or incurrent pore is intracellular. For example, it is a canal through a single large tubular or and having highly contractile porocyte cells communicating outside with the spongocyte. Now physiology. No adult sponge is capable of locomotion. It means all the adult sponges are sedentary in life. They cannot move or they cannot have ability of locomotion, and some are quite devoid of contractile power except for changes in the porocytes. Most do have at least local contractile powers that appears to be restricted to within 3 or 4 mm of the point of strong stimulus. It means all the animals of genus Leucocelonia are not movable, or they do not have capacity of locomotion in adult phase, or by any stimulation they can move 3 to 4 mm with the strong stimulation. Reactions are most noticeable when stimuli are applied to the region of the osculum. All reactions are slow and 1 to several minutes escapes before the responses become noticeable. Sponges are devoid of sensory or nerve cells. The contractile responses mentioned above are therefore direct reaction to stimuli under normal condition. All the apertures, including ostia and oscula, of a sponge are widely open, and a current of water flow in through the incurrent opening or ostia and out through the osculum. The water current are caused by beating of the flagella of the coenocyte cells. This flow bring food and provided opportunity of gaseous exchange. It means help in respiration also, and the elimination of metabolic waste. It means excretory waste. The structure of sponge is such that the flow of water passes the coenocytes area quite slow. The food comprises the plankton, microscopical animals and plants, and bits of organic matter. It appears that food particles adhere to the collar or are coat between the collar of the adjacent coenocytes. The food particles are ingested into the coenocytes or passed directly into the underlying amebocytes. Some observers think that food particles are also taken through the epidermal cells or the pinocoderm. Digestion is always intracellular, as in protozoans occurring in food vacuoles, which are acidic at first and alkaline later. Undigestible particles are ejected from the amebocytes and find their way into the outgoing current through the osculum. Enzymes. Protein digesting enzymes similar to the trypsin, pepsin, renin, rhepsin, lipase, invertase, amylase have been identified in some sponge extracts in some cases. Since sponges usually contains bacteria and other organisms, it is not clear that the enzymes come from the cell of sponge. Digested food is stored in certain amebocyte cells as a form of glycogen, glycoprotein, and lipoproteins. Respiration and elimination of metabolic waste are accompanied by osmosis without the aid of special structures. Now, we will discuss about the reproduction. Leucocephalonia reproduce both asexual and sexually manners. First is asexual reproduction. Leucocephalonia reproduce asexually by budding. In budding, Leucocephalonia sprout new horizontal branches which grow over rocks and other substrata and give rise to erect wedge-shaped individuals or new Leucocephalonia. When the upright branches attain sufficient size, the top break through as oscula. Leucocephalonia has also remarkable power of regeneration. Any piece of Leucocephalonia is broken, or any piece of broken Leucocephalonia is capable of growing into a complete individuals. It means they have high capacity of regeneration. This process is slow, and the months and years may be required before size is attained. It means the growing rate is very slow. Now we will discuss about sexual reproduction, or the second method of reproduction. Sexual reproduction takes place by the formation of gametes, for example, ova and sperms. Leucocephalonia is hermaphrodite, it means it has both sexes of male and female. Because both the gametes are formed in the body of same individuals, so gonads are altogether absent. The gametes are, however, formed by the differentiation, says gametogenesis. It means formed by the differentiation of amebocyte cells, that can also be say gametogenesis. Gametogenesis is a process of formation of gametes of sperm or ova. Cross fertilization occurs, which is internal. The sperms are drawn in the body of Leucocephalonia with the water current, which fertilize the ova. The development of the Leucocephalonia have been described by the Metnikoff in 1879 and Minchin in 1896. Now, development of Leucocephalonia. The fertilized egg undergoes equal and holoblastic cleavage to form an oval holoblastula called coeloblastula. The coeloblastula is composed entirely of a narrow flagellated shell except at the posterior pole, where there is a group of round non-flagellated cells. These are believed to be archaeocytes, which form all future archaeocytes of the sponge. These, together with the adjacent flagellate cells, which there upon lose their flagella. These, together with adjacent flagellated cells, wander into the anterior and fill it with a mass of cells. The resulting larva is thus a stereogastrula that can be say parenchymula and at inner mass of amoeboid cell. The parenchymula larva swims freely for a some hour, then it attached by the anterior pole and develop into a plate with a irregular outline. The amoeboid cells, that is anterior cells found in mesenchyma, migrate to the external surface and form the epidermis, that is also called pinacoderm and mesenchyme. The flagellated cells are thus enclosed and become the coenocytes. A central spongocyst appear and osculum break through and spicules are secreted. After a few days of attachment, the larva is converted into the adult esconoid sponge. Thank you. This video is prepared for the student of English medium. I hope they will be benefited by this. Thank you.